everybody hear me okay? Alright, okay. Along with Jessica, who we want to thank her for actually posting this and putting this all together. Jessica, along with everybody else who helped to make this event happen, we thank everybody for being here. I want to go over, first of all, a little more of just some guidelines before we march, okay? First of all, this is a family-friendly event. We have all the kids over by the trees. They're going to be walking in the back, but please be aware, we don't want to infringe on anybody's First Amendment, right? However, just be respectful that it is a family-friendly event. So I think you know what that means, all right? Second, we do not have permission to block traffic or be in these streets. Please, everybody stay on the sidewalk. We know it's going to take a long time for everybody to walk down the sidewalk, but it can be done. Those sidewalks are really wide. There can be 10 people wide. So stay on the sidewalk. Don't block traffic. We need to adhere to all the traffic signals. So there is going to be one of us with the yellow vest. We are just here to help facilitate people moving along and keep people safe at the intersection. So there will be actually a policeman and one of us with a yellow vest at each intersection so we can adhere to the traffic signals, okay? Nobody wants to get a jaywalking ticket today. That'd just be silly, right? We have more important things to deal with. Make sure that whatever you carry in, you carry out. Please pick up all your litter. That includes any kind of water bottles, cigarette butts, head droppings. There will be some of us going by afterwards to pick up anything that's left. So if you're worried about giving out flyers and people throwing them down, but please make a conscious effort to pick up your litter. We're going to be going down the sidewalk on the right-hand side to the farmer's market, make a loop, and then come back on the following side. There are restrooms at the farmer's market if anybody needs it. There are also restrooms.
If you would, please, sir, please remove yourself from the statue, sir.
Sir, you have to get off the statue. Unless you want to become part of the statue. Okay, so, first of all, I want to just say that if you're new to the issue of GMOs, or whether you're an old hand at it and doing it for years like me, you are making a difference just by being here. You are making a statement. You're taking a stand against GMOs, against not knowing what's in your food. We have a right to know what's in our food. If we don't know, then we can't make an intelligent choice. It is our choice to buy something that has a GMO or not. I can't imagine that anybody would if you know all the science against it, but without the knowledge, they are taking away that right to choose. Okay, this, Dallas, y'all are awesome. This is a worldwide event. The first march started in New Zealand. Then it went to Australia and Japan, and it is moving across the globe. Monsanto will have. I want to suggest not just going home and staying to yourself and going, okay, I'm not going to buy this. Speak to people, always politely. My suggestion is always to speak to your grocer. Talk to him about what's in your food. If you see something that you don't like, tell him politely that you don't want to buy this because it's GMO. Please carry products that are organic or non-GMO. You have to understand this is all consumer-driven. The companies absolutely are going to look at their bottom line. Personally, I had an alternative broadcast for 2 years. I constantly told people to call companies of food that you like and tell them, ask them, what is in your food? Is this organic? Is this GMO? If they say no, I say, well, why doesn't it say certified? Why doesn't it say non-GMO? I'm sorry, I like your product, but I will not buy it until I know for sure that it is non-GMO. They're going to look at that bottom line. If they start losing dollars, they're going to have to try and find another source for what's in their product. Also, be proactive. If you see a petition, oh, just sign it. Call your congressman, call your representative, call your senator, anytime there's a bill going on. They don't always listen to us, but the more people that call them, the more they're going to realize that whatever Monsanto pays them to vote against us, they are not going to have a job at the end of their term. I probably gave out the number to the White House more than anybody of any radio show. Call the White House. If you don't know your congressman or your representative, call the White House. You can find it. In fact, I will post something on our page, how to find your representative, so you can always make calls. It's just being proactive, and it doesn't take that much time to call a company and tell them. Okay, so just one other thing. We had almost 2,000 people that responded on our website. They are awesome. We are going to continue the website. It may have a different name, possibly. It may have a different picture, but we will continue with updates. Any future projects, any whatever is happening. I know some people keep asking about t-shirts. Jessica, she was so nice to put together the whole t-shirt buying project. Some people want t-shirts. She will put together another group if you still want to get March Against Monsanto t-shirts. So keep checking back on the website. We will continue to have updates and about anything that's future GMO that's going on. Okay, so.
Y'all ready to march?
Yeah. Okay. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna all
head north, young girl, right?
No GMOs! No GMOs! No GMOs! Very back.